I'm Karl Kern from the University of Arizona, and I've been asked to interview and comment on the AVOID trial, a very interesting, provocative trial about the use of oxygen in acute myocardial infarction. Dion Stub, the principal investigator, is with me. Dion, welcome. We're glad that you had time to come down from Canada to the warm weather of Chicago.
No, thanks, Dr. Kern. Pleasure to be here.
Why don't you just begin by telling us the background of this study and what it's all about?
As you know, I think, you know, for many years it's been international practice that we commonly give, almost as a first response, oxygen to patients with suspected myocardial infarction or acute coronary syndrome. You know, our first aiders do it, paramedics do it, nursing staff in the cath lab. It's almost this ubiquitous carryover response, I suppose, to treatment from over 50 years ago that really hasn't been put under the scrutiny of modern-day randomised controlled trials. And maybe more concerningly is that there's increasingly physiological evidence that if we do give oxygen to patients who are normoxic, we can quickly render them hyperoxic or give them significantly high levels of oxygen, and this in turn can lead to increase in coronary vascular resistance, reduction in coronary blood flow, production of free radicals, microcirculation impairment, and that all may contribute to reperfusion injury. So there's, I suppose, growing concern that maybe this common practice is not the best thing for patients with AMI. And that was really the hypothesis that the AVOID trial tried to answer. Does the common practice of giving oxygen to patients without hypoxia cause increased myocardial injury in patients with STEMI?
So this was an investigator-initiated project, as I understand. Is that
yeah,
right?
So the trial was coordinated by Ambulance Victoria and their research division in Melbourne, Australia, and really in collaboration with nine of the big tertiary STEMI centres in Melbourne, and with support from not-for-profit organisations. But yeah, it was a very much a pragmatic investigator-initiated trial to try and answer this very common, you know, fundamental first aid practice.
Well, give us kind of the nitty-gritty of how you did it and what you found.
Yeah, so patients could only be randomised by Victorian-trained paramedics, and they included all patients who described ischemic symptoms for less than 12 hours, had a pre-hospital 12-lead ECG that was suggestive of ST elevation MI, and importantly, were not hypoxic on a pulse oximeter, and that was defined for this study as an oxygen saturation greater than or equal to 94%. They had preserved conscious state, and at that point, the ambulance paramedics would open randomization opaque envelopes, and that would instruct them either to not give any oxygen or to give oxygen at 8 litres per minute via a mask. And then that oxygen therapy continued through to the emergency department, the cath lab, and then when the patient was stable on the ward.
And what did you find?
Yeah, so the co-primary endpoint of the study was myocardial infarct size on the routine biomarkers of CK and troponin I. And we found a significant 25% increase in creatinine kinase release, both that was mean peak as well as area under the curve, and that was with a p-value of 0.01. And that was in the oxygen group, so it looked like increased myocardial injury in those that were given oxygen. And the troponin result was not as significant. There was no significant difference, though the curves look very similar to CK with this non-significant 20% trend, but the confidence intervals were too large.
And the total number involved?
Yeah, so we randomised 638 patients pre-hospital, and that because of the pre-hospital non-confirmed STEMIs, that ended up being 441 patients with STEMI. And we then went on and offered all the patients cardiac MRIs at 6 months as a measure of final infarct size, and 139 patients ended up having a cardiac MRI, and that was interesting, again, this similar trend to increased myocardial injury with patients that were given oxygen, with, again, this 30% increase in late gadolinium enhancement.
And my understanding was that was a significant difference also.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's actually probably the bottom line, is that by infarct sizing, it looks like oxygen therapy for the normoxic acute MI patient may not be necessary and perhaps even harmful.
Yeah, it's a relatively small trial. I think it's important it was done in the pre-hospital and in-hospital settings. It'd be nice for it to be confirmed with hard clinical endpoints with a larger study that, you know, our Swedish colleagues are actually undertaking at the moment. But yeah, as a clinician, I'd have concerns about giving high flow oxygen to patients with normal oxygen saturations.
Do you think Mona's finally dead?
It's possible.
Yeah. Thanks very much. We've enjoyed being here at the Scientific Sessions in Chicago.